I was working further on that sawtooth generator that I published a few days ago, and I want to make it definite with, say, kind of neat encasing anyway. Here is that circuit again. Schematic is in an earlier video. Here is the power supply. Looks quite strange, but has inside a transformer of 15 milliampere at 9 volts. That's enough. You can also operate that circuit on 12 volt anyway. So I had to mount components, electronic components, to the front here. This is the potentiometer that sets the frequency. I make a switch with which I can switch in four different capacitors. I make that with two of these switches. Of course, you can also use a switch with one mother contact and four separate contacts to which the capacitors are soldered. This video is in fact only about the, say, what we call double earth connection. On the underside of that wooden plate, we have here tin plate, and the kit has the only aim to take away the sharp pieces when that tin plate is cut. And here the circuit again, and the whole setup is this. This is the earth plate on the underside of the electronic circuit, and I'm gonna drill a hole here and take a wire to the other side, and then we have here the minus of the circuit. That's this wire, and this wire goes to the one and only point, that is the earth connection. That will be here in this hole. I use very, say, primitive electrodes to take out the signal out of this no, sorry, sawtooth wave oscillator. In many cases, I use, for instance, this, and that means that here we have the central earth connection of the circuit. I will mount here this kind of screw, fasten it on the other side, on the front here. So that will be my earth connection and also the minus of the circuit. And what I want to tell here is that when you do that and you want to make another earth connection in, say, such a setup, that second earth connection, say it's here, it's going to be here in this location. Here, you cannot mount that, solder that on the same mass plate. At least this applies to audio circuits, not to high frequency circuits. There is always in real high frequency circuits, and I publish quite a few on my YouTube channel, say a certain ground plate. Want to show that when I can find. One moment, please. Yes, here it is. This is, for instance, a high frequency circuit here, and you see here that the mass, the ground, is one copper plate. one complete copper plate to which all the minus connections in this case are directly soldered. So that's another situation. This situation differs from this situation where we have a circuit that has to operate in the audio band, in fact, or perhaps 100 kilohertz, and where we have a electronic circuit mounted on an isolated board that is connected on one location to the shielding, the mass and the earth, and that's here. So that's very, very important, and that's also the reason why you see here that I made a carving with a knife, took out the template, so I cut it here with a knife, this location, and that second ground is not directly connected to the earth. And of course, this here we have a very short distance from the ground electrode, the minus electrode, the mass electrode, to that other electrode here that's also on mass. So in fact, it will not differ very much when I had directly mounted this second mass electrode or soldered it directly here to the mass plate. But it's a kind of principle that you have to take in account when you make electronic circuits. There's only one and only mass connection in these kinds of circuits. Be it an amplifier, audio amplifier, preamplifier, very important with preamplifiers. They are in fact vulnerable to this problem, and the one and only mass connection is here and is important. So I hope it was a little bit clear. So there's a kind of shielding here, electromagnetic shielding. This is template that's glued to the triplex board, the wooden board on the outer side, and that gives enough shielding because we have here a circuit that works on maximum 16 kilohertz, and that means that there could be a slight hand effect when you don't shield such a circuit properly for electromagnetic influences. And in these cases I always use this setup, the backside shielded, the front is shielded, and the cover that will cover it all is not shielded. But I have to say, you can use this principle for audio amplifiers, and in that case it's a good advice to also shield, say, the part here. So, with template or whatever, template is the best shielding, by the way. Iron, steel, aluminium doesn't shield so much, at least in this case, with audio amplifiers, etc. So, also, when it gets critical, you also can use ear shielding. Template, glue template in from beer cans or other steel cans. There are also aluminium cans on the market, but steel is of course the best way, and soldering of aluminium is very, very difficult. Anyway, that was more or less all to tell. Working further on that sawtooth generator, I think it will be ready this evening, almost sure, and then I have a device with which I can do more experiments in audio filters for musical purposes, music purposes. They use, as far as I could see, a sawtooth wave, and I also had a comment that square waves are used to generate certain, say, sounds. In the audio band, going from, say, 20 Hz up to 18 kHz. Very important that one point shielding, and of course when the distance to an other electrode is longer, here it's very short, this gets more critical. To prevent, say, hum caused by earth currents. So currents that flow inside the earth plate of your amplifier or whatever.